from Blue Steel Equestrian, and for our grooming guru today, we are going to be showing you how to do a tail plait. We have Bubbles. We have Bubbles' beautiful bum today, and our awesome Luigi, who will be holding him for me, and our products from our shop. We have elastics. I bought black and white elastics because I wasn't too sure which one would go well with Bubbles' tail. And we have our Show Sheen finishing mist, which is a detangler and also a shiner. And the most important is our tail brush from Blue Steel Equestrian. My outfit is also from Blue Steel Equestrian, my beautiful blue pants, my amazing long boots, and my espoir shirt. Also, please don't forget to subscribe at the little button at the bottom of the left-hand screen where I'm pointing. That's very, very important, as well as liking our Facebook page and Instagram page. I'm going to start off by just giving Bubbles' tail a little bit of a brush out because it is a bit knotty, as you can see. So I'm gonna spray a little bit of the Show Sheen finishing mist on it just to help detangle the knots. I'm giving it quite a bit of a spray because it was a bit knotty. So when I brush a tail, I always start with little bits and pieces. I don't do the whole tail at once because otherwise it can get quite knotty. And I always stand to the side of the horse, even though Bubbles doesn't kick, but you can never say never with a horse. So the reason why I'm doing this before the tail plait is so that I can get all the knots out without having to do it afterwards and risking damaging the plait. Good boy, Bubbles. You really know how to get your tail in a tangle, boy. Can definitely feel how the spray has really helped get his tail nice and soft. And his knots detangled. Oh, that was quick and easy. This is amazing. I am in love with it. It is great. Look how beautiful and silky his tail is. So soft. This product is amazing. If you're wanting, it's called Finishing Mist Show Sheen Absorbine. It's really important to not have the top of the tail too clean and too soft. That is why I didn't spray any of the detangler at the top. This is because it will make plaiting a little bit difficult because the pieces of hair will just slip through the plait and your fingers. So it makes it a little bit more difficult to actually hold in the plait while you're plaiting. Right, now let's start plaiting. I'm going to have an elastic on my finger just so that I've got one when I finish the plait so it doesn't all fall apart. And I'm decided to use a black elastic because his tail has got quite a bit of black in it, so it won't stand out as much as the white. I'm using the Volthausen elastics. They are on our web shop if you are looking for them. I love them. They are quite nice and thick and they're quite stretchy as well, and they're quite hardy, so they don't break easily, and I just prefer them. Okay, let's get started. Good boy, Bubbles. Just making sure Bubbles knows that I'm standing right behind him. And he is very relaxed today, so I'm just keeping an eye on his ears and his face just to see if he does start getting upset that I just move away from his back end. And if it was a horse that I didn't know, I wouldn't be so confident standing behind him. Bubbles is a baby, and this actually is his first tail plait. So we're just going to take it nice and slow and easy and just go with the flow. Good boy, Bubbles. As a beginner, it's always best to start with more hair than too little hair. As you get more and more confident in plaiting, you can always take less and less hair. So if I were a beginner, I'd always start with the top pieces a little bit bigger so that you've got something to hold. So I'm going to do that today just so that everybody can see. So you take one piece from the left and one piece from the right. You make it into one. Then you take a piece from the left and a piece from the right. And then what you do is you gradually start taking pieces every single time from each side and you add it into the plait. So you do a normal plait and you start taking pieces from the side. Another thing you can actually do is if you are struggling to start the plait, you can put in a little elastic. This is just for practice at home. So you can tie the top, because sometimes it's difficult to actually hold the two pieces together. So you can tie a little ponytail at the top. And then obviously as you get more and more confident, you won't need the elastic. So this is just to show you how to make it easier and how to actually get your tail plait started. Because sometimes getting the tail plait started is the most difficult part of the whole tail plait.
Okay.
So I'm going to leave the elastic here just to show you how you can actually do it with the elastic there. So I'm going to take pieces from left to right. I'm adding this piece to the original little piece. It's also important that you keep your pieces nice and tight, or as tight as you possibly can, so that the tail plait is nice and firm. Good boy, Bubbles. I think Bubbles is enjoying this. The first few pieces are always the most difficult because it is where the hair at the top of the tail isn't the longest. Good boy. The thing about a tail plait is that it is actually just practice. So you can see my little pieces of hairs aren't the biggest, but they're not the smallest, as I am demonstrating to you. And like I said before, it's actually easier to do it with bigger pieces when you are practicing and learning how to do a tail plait. And then as you get more confident, you can take less and less hair. Bubbles actually has a really nice tail to plait because he hasn't got short pieces at the top. Also really important to keep an eye on while you are plaiting is that it is going straight down the middle, because sometimes the middle plait can go a bit skew. And that's just from pulling it tighter on the one side than the other. Okay, I'm going to take a piece from the left, put it in, plait it, and then take a piece from the right. Add it to the plait, plait it, take a piece from the left. Add it in, plait it. And take a piece from the right, and as you can see, I'm adding it to the piece that's on the side, putting it over, and again, putting it to the side piece, and over, and to the next side. Good boy, Bubbles. You're being so good. Good boy. So, as you can see, I'm taking the hair all the way from the back. So there isn't any hair or tail pieces floating around. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. So hit that subscribe button at the bottom of the screen to get more of how-tos and ride of the weeks and everything that we're doing at Blue Seal Equestrian and getting to know the team. It really is a fun page and we are having loads of fun interacting with everybody. So yeah, join the team. The YouTube team. Three quarters of the way down. So normally when you're doing a tail plait, well, I normally go three quarters of the way down his dock, and that gives you a nice beautiful view of his tail as well. Not too low because that will just look a bit silly. As you can see, I'm actually finding it a bit easier and it's going a bit quicker as we come closer to the end of the plait because the pieces are nice and long and they're a lot easier to hold. It's also really important to practice tail plaits at home if your horse hasn't had a tail plait before, because some horses do find it a bit funny, like a funny feeling. So definitely practice at home if you are going to go to a showing show, so that make sure that you don't have any surprises in your showing class. Right, this is going to be my last little piece to add to the tail, and I'm now going to plait down a normal plait, but I'm going to keep it still as firm as possible. My hands are getting a little bit of a cramp, but every now and then I just shake out the fingers, but making sure I've got a nice hold on the plait. This plait is going to go not all the way down, but let's just do a little bit more. Leo, won't you please get me that black elastic that's lying on the floor? And then you can actually get me another one out the packet. Right, I am happy with that. Now, I'm going to tie it. Boy, Bubbles, let's give him a little pat because he's being very, very well behaved. Now we're going to finish off the plait. We're going to take the end, so where the elastic is, and we are going to push it up the plait slightly and just make sure that it's not sticking out. We are going to fasten it. Stand, boy. Good boy. Good boy. Fasten it there. Got another elastic in my pocket. Just find which pocket it's in. Make it nice and neat. I am so happy with the way this tail plait came out. I think it looks absolutely beautiful. And for finishing touches, if there are any loose hairs, you can always just take some gel and just fasten the hairs down. But Bubbles doesn't have loose hairs, so I'm very happy with this plait. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add a bit of show sheen finishing mist to his tail and then also to the tail plait, so he has that extra shine. Make his tail nice and puffy. Good boy, Bubbles. And that is how you do a tail plait. You can buy all these products that I use to do this beautiful tail plait at www.blue-steel.co.za, or you can pop into our store in Port Elizabeth, South Africa. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and drop us a comment if you have any questions about our tail plaiting, as well as if you have any other suggestions on what you would like us to show you. A tail plait should be done on the day of your class, and it should be taken out when you are finished riding for the day. It is important not to leave it in overnight because it is tight on their tails and it's not very comfortable. Not very comfortable to leave it in for days on end. So I suggest that you do it before your class or the morning of your class and take it out when you're finished. For now, we are going to put the red light on for Bubbles because it is a bit chilly in PE, and so he can warm up, and I'm going to give him a little treat because he has been so well behaved. And while he is relaxing, I'm going to take his tail plait out. To take a tail plait out, it is very easy. You take the elastics out, and don't drop the elastics on the floor because it won't be very good if your horse eats them. You just slowly let the plait come out and you put your fingers on the pieces of hair that you took from each side, and it just slowly and gently slides out. Oh, these red lights are nice and warm. And take your little helper out of the top and give your horse a nice little tail scratch. Good boy, Bubbles. Bubbles loves his royal feed, so he's going to get a little royal feed snack. Oh, okay. So eating the sugar-free. Hey, boy, is that nice? Oh, he's loving that. Good boy. Ha 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 ha.